Welcome to a video on how to factor a difference of squares. To factor a difference of squares, we need to be able to recognize perfect square factors. So if we have a binomial where the first term is a perfect square, the second term is a perfect square, and we have a difference, it will factor into the quantity a plus b times the quantity a minus b. So for example, if we have x squared minus 25, x squared is a perfect square, 25 is a perfect square, and therefore x squared minus 25 factors into x plus 5 times x minus 5. Notice once we recognize the terms as perfect squares, we take one of the factors and use it to create our binomials, where one is a sum and one is a difference. And again, remember, since multiplication is commutative, meaning we can change the order, it doesn't matter whether we have the plus 5 here or the minus 5 here, and vice versa, as long as one is a sum and one is a difference. Now there's one more thing we should note. If we have a sum of squares, it will not factor and is prime. So we can only factor a difference of squares, not a sum of squares. So if we want to factor x squared minus 81, we should recognize the first term's a perfect square, the second term's a perfect square, and we have a difference. And since 9 squared is equal to 81, one factor will be x plus 9, and the other factor will be x minus 9. Now just for an illustration, let's go ahead and multiply this out to check it. We have four products, 1, 2, 3, 4. X times x, that would be x squared. And then we have x times negative 9, minus 9x. Our next product will be 9 times x, that's plus 9x. And then 9 times negative 9 will be negative 81, so we'll write down minus 81. Notice the middle terms are opposites, and so this does check. We have x squared. This shows why one has to be a sum and one has to be a difference. This results in two terms being opposites, giving us the difference of squares. Next we have 64x squared minus 49. Again, this is a perfect square, so is this, and we have a difference. If we needed to, we could show some work here. 8x to the second power does give us 64x squared, and 7 squared does give us 49. So if that's helpful, we can show this. What that tells us is one factor will be 8x plus 7. The other factor will be 8x minus 7. And now this difference of squares is factored. Let's go and take a look at a couple more examples. These next two aren't quite as straightforward. Here we have x to the fourth minus 16. Well, x to the fourth is a perfect square, so is 16. And we have a difference. Now x to the fourth is a perfect square because x squared raised to the second power does equal x to the fourth, and of course 4 to the second does equal 16. So our two factors would be x squared plus 4 and x squared minus 4. Now we have to be careful here because this factor here is still a difference of squares. Now this one is a sum of squares, so it can't be factored. But this can be factored again. So this first factor would stay the same. And this is going to factor into two more binomials. X squared is a perfect square, and so is 4. So we'd have x plus 2 and x minus 2. Remember, 2 squared is equal to 4. So this resulted in three binomial factors. And in our last example, this first term is not a perfect square, and neither is 18. But remember, the first step in any factoring problem is to look for the greatest common factor. And 2 does happen to be a common factor between these two terms. If we factor 2 out, we're left with x squared minus 9, and this binomial is a difference of squares. X squared is a perfect square, 9 is a perfect square, and we have a difference. So we can factor this again. We bring down our factor of 2, and then we'd have an x plus 3 and an x minus 3. Again, remember 3 squared is equal to 9, and the factors of x came from the factors of x squared. Okay, that's going to do it for factoring difference of squares. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you for watching.